dusty Delta day. I was out chopping cotton and my brother.
The song Ode to Billy Joe speaks of the tragic love of two young people and the ways of the South. Since 1967, it has been one of the great folk songs in America's musical history. The woman who wrote it is Bobbie Gentry.
Ode to Billy Joe had been a short story that I had written. I condensed it to verse. I remember the record was released on July 10th, and 3 weeks later it was the number one record.
Today, Billy Joe McAllister jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge.
Songs are seldom made into movies. Until 1975, Miss Gentry resisted all efforts to have her song put on the screen. But now a company is filming it in and around Greenwood, Mississippi, where the Tallahatchie River joins the Yabalusha to become the Yazoo. This is Delta Country and the first home of Bobbie Gentry. She came back to join director Max Baer and meet some of the actors as he translates the love story of Billy Joe McAllister and Bobbie Lee Hartley to the screen. The event stirred old memories.
I was born on a farm in Chickasaw County up in Northeast Mississippi. When it came time to start to school, I moved here to the Delta and lived here into my teenage years when I started formulating the characters in Billy Joe.
The characters came to life before Bobbie Gentry's eyes through actor Robbie Benson, who plays Billy Joe McAllister, and Bobbie Lee Hartley, played by Glynis O'Connor.
Well, I could charge you maybe half a dollar for my average.
Ain't worth but a quarter. Whole bridge ain't worth but a quarter.
Bobbie Lee, I want to talk to you.
Billy Joe, let me be. I'm 15 years of age. Now, you may think that's old, but my papa sees me as nothing but a child.
Well, your papa is clearly behind the times.
He is also on the poach.
Cut it.
They have called the girl Bobbie in the movie. I didn't actually ever have a name for her in the song. She has a great deal of strength, and I think out of all of the characters, she was the one that was best equipped to rise out of her environment and circumstances.
Actor Sandy McPeak plays Bobbie Lee's father.
He lived.
People always trying to pick me up. I do declare, what is happening to the staff?
Sorry, my mistake. You let the dog go? Roll. I like all of the characters in the story, and I do understand them all. It's almost as though they were programmed from the very beginning, that they really have little choice as to how they're going to react as life moves along for them. The characters of Mama and Papa are based on close members of my family. Of course, it was looking at all of them from a young girl's viewpoint.
You were up late last night.
I was reading.
The good book?
Oh, yes, Mama. It was a good book.
Guess you're getting to that time.
I guess so.
Sometimes when the sap gets to rising, sometimes a girl has to count to 10.
I'm way past 100, Mama.
Sometimes a girl has to count to 1,000.
How high did you count with Papa?
As I recall, 844 by twos.
Max Baer's relationship with Bobbie Gentry extends back to the time when he asked her to do the score of his first film, Macon County Line. Out of that experience, she decided to let him and producer Roger Camras make a movie based on her song, Ode to Billy Joe. They came to her with a screenplay by Herman Rauscher of Summer of 42 fame, and a promise to avoid the cliches and stereotypes of the American South. To accomplish this, they came to Bobbie Gentry country, and Baer peopled his film with faces as native to the area as the Big Barn, where he staged a square dance. The Tallahatchie Bridge in Bobbie Gentry's song is no more. There's another bridge close by that spans the Yazoo, and it was used for the filming. A massive crane was barged down the mighty waters and moored next to a small, narrow, one-lane wooden bridge. It was used to support the director and his crew.
There simply wasn't a choice to capture the true feel. We just had to be down here in this environment here in the Delta. It's hot and sticky and steamy and uncomfortable, and it's beautiful.
To be faithful to the spirit and meaning of Bobbie Gentry's song, Max Baer cast three native Mississippians who had never been in films before. Using them for a scene on the bridge, he hoped to capture those things Bobbie Gentry sang about.
Hey, you have to back up.
Don't say nothing for a while.
A lot of people have asked me about Ode To Billy Joe. It's a true story. And, of course, they wanted to know what was thrown off the bridge. And they seemed to be that was the message or the story that I was trying to tell. Actually, the story pointed out the particular way that people here in the South deal with the very real things in life, birth and death and tragedy and great joy. I think it's peculiar to this section of the country.
Oh, man. Well, first, he's just gonna have to back off.
Who is it?
I don't know. Well, we just have to stop acquainting with the decision.
Okay, you laughing a little bit when you come in? Fred, you're gonna have to back up.
We ain't backing up.
The way we work around here, first one on the bridge got the right of way.
We ain't from here.
That does give us a problem. Oh, so we just took the boat and decided to you. We're doing it back now. Come on.
Best you get out, girl.
Is deeply rooted in the South. Its characters, Billy Joe McAllister and Bobbie Lee, are like young lovers everywhere, at any time.
I love you, Bobbie Lee.
It's trouble.
I don't care.
Oh, Billy Joe.
Whoa!
Found some people that I felt would really treat Ode To Billy Joe in the way that I had conceived it, could really portray the story and tell it as the sensitive story as well as capturing the mystery that surrounded that tale.
Ah! Give me a baby.
A year is coming.
I am deprived, Bobbie Lee.
Oh, no, sir. You are by no means deprived. You had everything you're supposed to have.
Brother Mary, thank you, Thompson. They bought the store in Tupelo. There was a virus going round. Papa caught it and he died last spring.
A movie company has come to the South to make Ode To Billy Joe, taking Bobbie Gentry's classic folk song and bringing it to life on film.
And me, I spent a lot of time picking flowers.
Audiences will be filled with memories of a legend and with anticipation for the story of a tragic young couple and the unraveling of a long-kept secret.